Hello YouTube, Psycho Fox here. Welcome to the latest in my Redant Game Axe restoration set of videos. And as you can see, I've got the LCD monitor. Cost me 14 quid. And there it is. Really, really basic stuff. It's quite flimsily made, which is quite good. It'll be quite easy to take apart. It's 9 volt. Now, eventually, obviously, we'll be taking it out of this housing, but I've just left it in for testing at the moment. And I'll show you the setup I've got. Quite a bundle of wires. I've got the Game Axe with a Mahjong Famicom cartridge in it. AV out, this is the same lead I used for my Sega Nomad. It's got a SCART on it, but it's halfway along, it's got this little composite output. So I've got the video from that. Follow the wire. That is coming down to the video input on this LCD, and eventually this video input will be wired directly to the circuit board in that, as will the power. But at the moment I've got the external power for the LCD screen running off a 9 volt supply, and for anyone who's interested, the tip is positive on this. On this interchangeable head, the tip is positive. And I also did a bit of research last night, and the 9 volt for the Nomad tip is negative on that. It's different size to the Sega Nomad's input, but tip is negative. I think the Sega Game Gear PSU will work, that's the same polarity. But anyway, let's have a look at the setup. So if we flick the Nomad on, screen comes into life. Still got the plastic cover on it. So that's the Mahjong game. So this is just a sort of an external lash up, really, just to show what the new screen will look like when it's in. It's a 3.5-inch screen. Now this Game Axe is actually got a 4-inch screen. It's the FC868 there, which actually, doing a bit of research, this dates from 1997. So not as old as I thought. So it's probably borrowed quite heavily from the Sega Nomad, which is why they're very similar internally, circuit board wise. So it's getting a bit of glare off the screen there. So yeah, there's the Mahjong game. All the controls work on the Game Axe. I've tested them out. A bit odd to test on this Mahjong game because I don't really know what I'm doing. So I went and bought one of these things, which is a 60 to 72 pin adapter, and that'll let you play NES games straight into the cartridge slot. I mean, obviously stick out an absolute mile when you got it in. I mean, it's like that, it's very unwieldy, but it's really just for playing with the joypads on the telly, because if you play it handheld with that wiggling out the top, it's gonna crash. I mean, for the most part, you can always strip down your game cartridge, because the actual circuit board in here is only about that. The rest of it's just empty. So yeah, that's my little update. Thanks for watching.